Welcome back to our live video cryptocurrency trading series. Today we are talking about the Lightning Network and the first pizza purchase with the Lightning Network. That's right, you heard me, the first pizza purchase. Now the Lightning Network offers Bitcoin a lot of promise because it's supposedly the layer two savior for Bitcoin's scaling woes. So This is what Lightning Network enthusiasts have been waiting for. This guy, Laszlo Hanyek, who bought the original Bitcoin pizza back on May 22nd, 2010, for 10,000 Bitcoin, at the time worth about $40. Okay, this dude bought two pizzas for 10,000 Bitcoin. And that, you're hearing that correctly, that means that those two pizzas today would be worth $100 million. That's right, $100 million for two pizzas. But anyway, back in 2010, it was $41. He's paid 10,000 Bitcoin for them. And just yesterday, he bought the first pizza via the Lightning Network. Now, what exactly is going on with this Lightning Network? Well, the Bitcoin blockchain is extremely secure and robust, but that security comes at a price. Okay, Bitcoin has a hard size limit of 1 megabyte blocks, and it can only process 7 transactions per second. Compare that with 60 for Bitcoin Cash and 24,000 for Visa. Okay, so 60 here, Bitcoin Cash, 24,000 Visa, and 7 transactions per second for Bitcoin. So it's obviously a lot slower. It also has a 10-minute block time plus the requisite 6 confirmations. That means it adds up to a full hour for a confirmed transaction. That's a best-case scenario on the Bitcoin blockchain. Now, during the pre-Christmas Bitcoin mania, you can see here on the mempool backlog. The mempool is just the number of transactions that are waiting to be processed. So they're unconfirmed transactions. And going back to the pre-Christmas Bitcoin mania, it was close to 200,000 unconfirmed transactions. And transaction fees at that time rose as high as $40, and confirmations could take days. So this, you know, is obviously not a tenable situation for buying a pizza. Now, the Lightning Network promises to change all that. Here's what the Lightning Network looks like. It's a bunch of nodes. These are off-chain nodes. This is not a blockchain. These are off-chain nodes that what they do is they're off-chain peer-to-peer nodes that are governed by smart contracts. Okay, so that's what you're looking at when you look at the block at the Lightning Network. All right, peer-to-peer off-chain nodes. Now, these nodes are connected, obviously, to several other nodes. So if you look at some of them, have a lot of connections. So when you move them around, you can see that the other ones that move are connected. The more they move, the closer they are in connection. So that's how you can tell. So some of these obviously have a lot of connections, some of them just a few, but these are all private channels through which Bitcoin can be sent using some clever sleight of hand with smart contracts and digital signatures and multi-signature wallets. So that's what the Lightning Network is. And the bottleneck in Bitcoin arises because every single transaction has to be broadcast to the entire network. So when we talk about Lightning, we're talking about unicasting. So that's node to node on that network of private peer-to-peer nodes. Okay, now for Bitcoin, on the other hand, you're talking about broadcasting. So every transaction has to be broadcast to the entire network. Well, what is a transaction? Well, a Bitcoin is nothing more than a chain of transactions. Okay, but transactions are heavy on the Bitcoin blockchain because, you know, they have a lot of weight because no matter how small, every transaction contains amounts, a sender, a receiver, and a digital signature. Now, the amounts are in the forms of inputs and outputs. So, in other words, the way that you reference bitcoins is there's no actual coins. You're not holding any physical or even digital entities that are actual coins. What you're holding is proof that you own the private key that interlocks with the public address that is the terminus of a chain of transactions. And so how the way you prove that you own bitcoins is you reference previous transactions that end at your public address. And those transactions reference other previous transactions, et cetera, down the line. And every coin can be traced all the way back to its origin. Now, what this y ends up yielding is a pretty unwieldy sort of transaction where there are multiple inputs to add up to however many Bitcoin you want to send. Then there are multiple outputs. Okay, this is what you're sending the other person, and this is what you're sending back to yourself as change. And then there's from address to address. So there's amounts. The amounts are from inputs and outputs. The from addresses to addresses, and then the digital signatures. So you can see this is a pretty unwieldy structure considering that every single transaction, every micro Bitcoin, every Satoshi has to be broadcast to the entire network in this very, very heavy structure, which contains all that I just showed you, the sender, receiver, from address to address, the amounts consisting of inputs and outputs, and the digital signatures. The digital signatures are different for every single transaction. So a new unique signature is generated for each transaction. So this, you can see, this is a pretty heavy structure. And the Lightning Network solves all that with private channel peer-to-peer unicasting instead of broadcasting. And a multi-signature wallet that holds a Bitcoin balance for transactions. The savings in transaction weight is enormous because instead of a full accounts, amounts, signatures transaction for every micro Bitcoin, every Satoshi that has to change hands, there's simply an update to the balance sheet that each party digitally signs. So you start with a wallet address and a balance sheet. Okay, the wallet contains some Bitcoin, and then whenever a micro transaction happens on the Lightning Network between the nodes, that balance sheet is updated, and the parties involved sign the update. So instead of keeping track of each account, amount, to, from address, and digital signature, all that you're keeping track of is the balance, the ultimate balance between the parties in the digital wallet. And like I said, it's a multi-signature wallet, so both parties have to sign off on changes in the balance sheet. So balances replace microtransactions on the Lightning Network, and they're removed. The microtransactions are removed from the main chain, and it's only that when a channel is closed that the final balance sheet is saved to the main chain. So only after one of these channels is no longer being used, that's when the balance goes back to the main blockchain. So Lightning is far from perfect. It obviously has its detractors, as in everything Bitcoin, and some of those shortcomings that they point out, they rightly point out, is that it's suboptimal for large payments. The reliance on private nodes is kind of anathema to Bitcoin's ethic of decentralization. And there's also the issue of dispute resolution and how to deal with unresponsive peers. So if one of these nodes become unresponsive, then what do you do? Okay, so those are all issues that need to be resolved for Lightning to be fully utilized. But for now, a Lightning Network pizza transaction has taken place, And the Wall Street Journal said in an article that was entitled "Tech That Will Change Your Life" in 2018, they predicted that this year will be the year you will buy a pizza with cryptocurrency. So which crypto will it be? And will it be through the Lightning Network? Well, we'll see. Hopefully, we'll see together. I hope this video has given you some useful information that you can put to use today to make smarter, more informed, more research-based cryptocurrency investing decisions. Ciao for now.